When I visited Tenerife in August 2025, I was surprised to see a sign that said bathing prohibited. It's not because of any waves or of wind and weather and storm, but because the water was contaminated with bacteria. And that made me wonder a little bit, well, where do these bacteria actually come from, right? Why was this, are they actually a reason for the whole beach to be closed? Yeah, that's essentially something that I would like to explore in this video. So hi, hello and welcome again. Microbehunter here, I'm Oliver, and this YouTube channel we explore how microbes, how microorganisms influence our daily lives. Well, today I want to talk about a topic that upsets me a little bit, and it's also a slightly personal topic because on August 19th, 2025, I visited the natural swimming pools of Guarachico and Tenerife. It was a family holiday on the Canary Islands. It's a really beautiful place. And there are these natural pools which were formed by volcanic rock there. So it's obviously a very popular tourist destination as well. But just when we arrived, officials there were putting up signs. Swimming prohibited. So essentially what they did is they closed the whole area and you were not allowed to go into the water. So we of course also asked for the reason for the closure, and we were informed, we were told by the man who put up the signs, that the bacterial contamination of the water is far too high and it's not safe to go into the water. Well, luckily the pools, those natural pools, they were able to be reopened the next day, which unfortunately we did not know at that time. So the closure luckily was only for a short time. From what we were able to find out, the bacteria were likely carried in from the outside, from offshore, maybe by some water currents or so, even maybe possibly from a long distance. Still, it does show how vulnerable even natural and pristine environments can be. And I have to admit that I am, well, a little bit upset, not because I was not able to go into the water to have a swim, but rather I was upset because it kind of shows that there are indeed, many places in the world where untreated sewage water is directly dumped into the environment, into the ocean. And that is actually, can have an effect even on places that are very far away and very distant locations. And the cause for these beach closures are indeed, of course, contaminations by sewage water, which is wastewater. Beach closures like this are not unusual in the United States. In the year 2024, almost two-thirds of all tested beaches reached unsafe levels due to sewage contamination. And in the United Kingdom, there were even cases where large amounts of untreated sewage water was released into the ocean by a company. And on Boracay in the Philippines, it's actually one of the world's most famous island destinations, the situation became so bad that in 2018, the entire island was closed to tourists for half a year. Why? Because they needed that time for cleanup work. Sewage was dumped directly into the ocean, and this is basically where it starts to become also a little bit personal, because I remember Boracay quite differently. I myself visited the island back in the year 1986, so it's quite a long time ago, and at that time it was still a very untouched paradise, and I as a child at that time, we spent a beautiful week there, and I remember that the sand was as fine as a flower. But years of uncontrolled tourism basically ended up destroying the whole island. Yeah, untreated sewage was dumped into the ocean, and as a consequence, algae started to grow out of control, and of course, the health risks also increased. And from what I heard, now the situation seems to be somewhat under control now. Probably it's not completely resolved, but the situation is not better there. Now, I think it's ironic because, you know, we tourists, we go on a holiday to a beach, and the very hotel that we check in basically dumps our own sewage water into the ocean so that we're not able to swim there. Yeah, and on the positive side, it still does kind of show that if you do take active measures, like in the case of Boracay, then you can improve the situation. And also on the Canary Islands, they really started to crack down on illegal dumping of sewage, and the situation there also improved. So why were the beaches closed in the first place? Well, when wastewater is discharged directly into the rivers, into lakes, or into the ocean, then this introduces a high bacterial load, and lots of organic matter is also dumped into the water body. Now, this not only increases the health risks for swimmers, but it also fuels the growth of algae and also of so-called cyanobacteria. And these cyanobacteria are also able to produce toxins that can cause rashes on the skin or other problems. And besides E. coli, you can also find Salmonella, Shigella, Campylobacter, and even viruses in the sewage water. And when these are basically taken up because you accidentally swallow some of the water, then of course this can make you ill with stomach cramps, diarrhea, and fever. And in extreme cases, even cholera is possible. Now, nature is able to handle small amounts of sewage. It will then be broken down naturally. But when entire cities or communities dump their wastewater directly into the ocean, and of course, this overwhelms the environment. And I just plainly think it's just disgusting. Yeah. And if you want to see it also from an economic viewpoint, of course, people becoming ill after holiday, I mean, that's not really good public relations. It's not good PR. So it makes sense to close the beach for several reasons, therefore. Now, there are several different ways on how to check if the water is safe, but the traditional method would be to actually grow bacteria from the water sample. Microscopes, they do not help here in most cases because the bacteria are too few to be seen directly under the microscope. Yet they can still be a problem, right? Often the water also looks clean and there is no bad smell either, but the bacterial load can still be too high to be safe. So here's how it actually works and what is actually done. A water sample is taken and it's passed through a fine filter, and that filter is then placed on a special growth medium, and bacteria are now given time to multiply, to divide, right? And because they divide exponentially from one bacteria mix to mix 4, 8, 16, you get the idea, it always doubles every generation. It's possible for one single cell to grow into a whole visible colony. They have maybe a millimeter or two in diameter. And by counting these colonies, researchers, scientists are able to estimate how many bacteria were in the original water in the first place. And if the number is above a certain critical threshold, then of course the beach has to be closed. And the process isn't instant. Basically, it does take time for the bacteria to grow, so you have the results within probably around 24 hours. Now, to the frustrating part, I mean, we know how to prevent all of this. Yeah, communities need proper wastewater treatment. There have to be separate piping for sewage and for rainwater. And when you mix sewage water and rainwater together, then of course the drainage system become overloaded. And then, when there's much rain, and then the contaminated water can also overflow and spill out. Now you need to keep those two systems separate. And there must also, of course, be laws against illegal dumping of these the wastewater. And these laws actually also must be enforced. Communities may have to also invest in upgrading the water management system and in water treatment facilities. Yeah, and of course, I think those who produced the wastewater must also contribute their fair share in treating that water. Now, it's also not only up to the governments, of course, but yes, tourists themselves. I mean, they also, and locals, they also play a role, because disposing of trash properly and not polluting the water and respecting the environment is a very important part as well. And it starts with us as well. Now, we have the knowledge and the tools, but all too often not enough is done. And that's basically my complaint here, because I think clean water should be a norm, right? And it should not be the exception. There must also be consequences for those who do not adhere to the rules, because the contamination caused by a few can endanger everyone else's health. And I consider this, of course, unacceptable. Now, as big as the disappointment of the beach closure was, of course, there is something reassuring. However, the local authorities are testing the water quality, and appropriate measures were taken, namely the beach was closed, in the interest of public health. And just to clarify here, this beach closure was a single occurrence that I experienced, yes. So there were plenty of other beautiful beaches that were still open, but I think it's still reassuring that the local government actually is doing something to test the water quality to make it safe for the people there. Now, what I'm complaining about, however, is not the fact that the authorities closed the beach. Obviously not. Of course not. This is in the interest of public health, and it's important that the water quality testing is done. What I am rather complaining about is that there are still too many places where sewage is dumped illegally into the ocean and into rivers and other bodies of water. And I don't like it if the general public has to pay the price for the irresponsibility of a few. Yeah, and I also don't like to clean up the mess that others created. I mean, it's just a side issue here. Well, we know since ancient times that sewage water is a health risk. That's nothing new. Even the ancient Romans, they therefore built separate drainage and sewage systems to keep drinking water safe. And this was done long before bacteria were even known to exist. And in 1854, there was also a cholera outbreak in London, which was clearly linked to contaminated drinking water. So the knowledge is really there, right? And we know what has to be done. So let's do something about it. That's simply my proposal. And when sewage does close a beach, then don't blame the bacteria. I think rather it's a sign of failed or missing infrastructure. It's a lack of awareness. It's maybe cost cutting in many cases, and of course a question of laws and enforcement of these laws. I think it's also a question of values, right? Because we have to ask ourselves, is how important is clean and healthy water to us? Right, and the good news is, I know that this is now going to be a little bit sarcastic, so apologies here. The good news is that microbiologists apparently will never run out of work in this case. Well, that's it from my side. I wish you still happy microbe hunting as always. See you in the next video, and there is a subscribe button somewhere. All the best. Bye bye.